Tuesday. Welcome to our wonderful webinar this afternoon, all around a very important topic, financial literacy, especially in middle school. So we're so glad that you are all here joining us today. If you don't know me, I'm Pedro Caro. I'm coordinator of CCR, Riverside County Office of Education. I'm happy to work with everyone here. As a former middle school counselor myself, I believe in this work very much and used to love teaching these lessons to my kiddos. So very much about this work. I want to introduce one of our co-presenters today, Mr. Kevin Gudley.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for attending here in this meeting. Yes, my name is Kevin Gudley, Riverside County Office of Education in the Leadership, Innovation, and Outreach Department. Looking forward to this work that we're doing with respect to Dr. Gomez's financial literacy initiative. When we think about Dr. Gomez's financial literacy initiative and how important he felt it was to ensure that all students throughout Riverside County schools understand the components of in its simplest, it's basic, little, other behavior. When you connect that with research, a coalition for personal financial literacy, in their 2010 research, 2% of all American high school seniors receive a failing grade in financial literacy. Another figure is that only 23% of kids surveyed indicated they talked to their parents frequently about money. Another research from American Psychological Association that 33% of Americans have a dollar retirement and 66% of adults are literacy tests. So literacy is that, you know, many when we talk to, as well as Americans, they prioritize consumption over investment, short-term plan, short-term, long-term plan. So the element that
hey Kevin, your sound's a little choppy, so we're doing our best. I don't know if you
We can hear you now. I'm going to switch locations. I'm in my house, and I'm going to get away from my kids and my wife. <it's> there. And I'm going to sit down in my room.
Go for it. No, I want them to hear because you've done some great research on the why. So please go for it. Now we can hear you, see you better. Please start. You can start over.
My apologies to everyone. I apologize for that. What I was saying is that part of our work here with the department that I work in, the Leadership, Innovation, and Outreach Department, is built around Dr. Gomez, as our county superintendent, his concerns over some of the detrimental aspects of financial literacy for our students in Riverside County. So what I was saying, there's a simple premise that he stated to us that people save too little, spend too much, incur too much debt and fail to understand how their behavior mortgages their future. What I would mentioned earlier, or after that, I should say, I mentioned with some of the organizations that do research on financial literacy, such as the Jumpstart Coalition for Personal Financial Literacy, found in 2019, 62% of all American high school students receive a failing score in financial literacy. Another figure was that only 23% of kids surveyed indicated that they talked to their parents frequently about money. The American Psychological Association in 2019 found that 33% of Americans have not saved a single dollar for retirement, and 66% of American adults are unable to pass a basic financial literacy test. There's also another indicator from Standard & Poor's Ratings Services Global Financial Literacy Survey for the United States, and it found that too many Americans prioritize consumption over savings, convenience over investment, short-termism over long-term planning. So some of those are very important factors that we took into consideration with ensuring that our financial literacy initiative at least captures or appeals to students when they look at their long-term futures and how that they want to prepare for investments and savings and also funding their college plans and desires. So we're looking forward to presenting different pathways, different connections over these next few months and year for financial literacy, particularly with middle school teachers as they embark on getting their kids engaged. I will add this final part. Financial literacy also includes entrepreneurial efforts or endeavors. And when you look at some of the programs that we have that not only trains kids to create their own products and businesses, but also organizations that help fund seed monies for students to start their own businesses on their school campuses. So we think we have a host of programs and trainings that will at least give middle school teachers an understanding of how they can engage their students. So with that in mind, I'm going to turn over this presentation to Jessica Golden and Mariana Biagioni. And I appreciate and look forward to it. Thank you.
And before Jessica gets on and she shares her screen, just a little reminder of housekeeping tips. I know folks are logging a little bit late. Just know this meeting is being recorded, so anyone can access this webinar and check it out later. We'll email that to you as well. In terms of engagement, we're here to serve you. We want to see all of your questions, answer all of your wondering. So please go ahead and use the chat feature or unmute yourselves if the presenters allow that to ask your questions. We want to learn from you what you're working on. We will stay on until every single question is answered. So please, please be confident, ask away. And then lastly, hasn't happened yet, but in case of a Zoom bomb or something like that, we'll just simply reboot and get back on track, no problem. So just thank you for being patient with us as we move through and glad you're here. Thank you, Jessica.
Yeah, thank you for the introduction, Kevin and Pedro. We're really excited to be here today. So I'm gonna go ahead and share my screen. So perfect introduction, you know, Kevin leading in of, you know, why financial education is important. And those stats and figures that he shared today are certainly the things that we are going to be leaning into and discussing throughout this presentation as we lean into middle school financial literacy. But before we kick off, I'm going to quickly introduce myself. I am Jessica Golden. I am our K-12 Senior Director for Districts. So my role is really working with our district partners, our county offices of ed, to think about the placement of our different programs at EVERFI and how they can fit in, support with your curriculum, and also just support with your different initiatives, such as the initiative in Riverside County Office of Education. My colleague Andee is not here today, but I did want to introduce her as she is really our go-to person for all of our schools. So any types of questions that you have, teacher training support, Andee is really that go-to person that can help support that. But I do have my colleague Mariana today. So she is going to be manning the chat for us. So Mariana has been working in California. Mariana, do you want to introduce yourself? Because you're also a product of Riverside County. So I think that's really incredible.
Yes. Hi, everyone. Mariana Biagioni. I am a product of Marietta Valley Unified, so proud of it. But I have been now at EVERFI for 6 years, and I'm the regional director for the Southwest region. And I'm excited to speak with all of you today. And yes, please chat any questions. I'll be chatting some things along the way, so feel free to chat anything along the way.
Great. So many of you are probably asking, okay, this is fantastic, but who is EVERFI? So who are these people and what is the work that they do at their company? So today we'll dive into those introductions, but then begin talking about who is EVERFI, our digital financial literacy resources, share current EVERFI teacher insight, and then actually get you into the platform. Because nothing's better than actually being able to see these programs live and how you might be able to implement them with your students. So for background on who EVERFI is, we're an education technology company focused on that whole child education, thinking about what it is that our students need beyond high school. We serve verticals within financial education, as we are talking about today, prevention ed, STEM, social emotional learning, and much more. So really thinking about, as myself, reflecting on what are the things that I wish I had had when I was a student, and thinking about how we can bring those to our students now, preparing them for the world that they are going to be facing. All of our programs are available at no cost thanks to local and national partners. These partners are coming in and funding these programs. This includes the digital access, any training, professional development, any support that you might need is always at no cost. Even if a partner switches out and says, hey, this year budgets are tight because of whatever reason, EVERFI will always continue to provide these programs at no cost. We know our teachers are embedding them into lesson plans. Our district partners are incorporating them into their scope and sequence and curriculum guides. We want to make sure that this is something consistent that you can lean on year over year. So in addition to this, we have really been scaling our impact, and we feel that digital resources are one of the ways that we're able to do exactly that. So we have worked with over 3.1 million K-12 learners over the last 11 years and really partner with over 30,000 schools. Specifically in California in the 2019-2020 school year, so last year, we had over 1,200 schools participating in one or more EVERFI programs and almost 125,000 students. We're on track this year to completely surpass this, which is incredible considering we have been in a pandemic with remote learning and all the other challenges that our students are facing, that US educators are facing. We're really happy to be a part of that solution to help support our students and educators. So in addition to providing our digital resources at no cost, I want to lay out some of the other benefits and perks of this sponsorship model. So all of our programs are available at no cost thanks to that different partners. These partners, in addition to being able to fund the programs, we're constantly keeping them updated. We want to make sure that this content is relevant to our students, that we are addressing current trends and topics within financial education, and all of your students have unlimited student licenses. So every school and teacher, as many students that want to access the program, will have access to get started. We also have our dedicated implementation team, which is Andee. So Andee is available to provide ongoing tech support, answer questions, think about the best practices for implementation in a classroom. And then I'm available to really think through what is that larger scale professional development opportunities within your districts, whether it's training schools site by site, or are we wanting to train, for example, all eighth grade counselors on specific programs. We're really here to be your thought partner and strategic thinkers. And we're also available to help map out our resources to your different curriculum maps, guides, and scope and sequences. So really think of Andee and I and Mariana too as your support team, really taking things off your plate in regard to any EVERFI collaboration and implementation. And then we also offer opportunities. This includes classroom visits. So it's so important to bring the community into your classroom. So with these different sponsors that are working in our communities, so Bank of Hemet, they are willing to do these classroom engagements where they come in, answer student questions, but they're also happy to do financial jeopardy with our students. So finding ways to really incorporate and help them see these real life applications of the concepts they are learning. And then we are going to really dive into this last piece under opportunities, but we offer hundreds of thousands of dollars every year in scholarships. And I know Catalina in some previous presentations have shared how many scholarship dollars go unanswered. So today I'm going to share three different scholarship opportunities available for California students. And then finally, impact. It is so important that we are measuring the knowledge gains of our students and seeing how this impacts not just your school, but your district. This can help you drive decisions and thinking about placement of programs. How is this impacting our specific students? Are they seeing the knowledge gains that we would want? I'm going to pause right there. Any questions about general EVERFI and our sponsorship model? And feel free, this isn't too big of a group. So if you want to come off mute, we are certainly happy to make this a more conversation style as well. Okay, great. So let's dive into the instructional resources. First, I'm going to share with you this giant menu. Today, we are really going to be leaning in on this left side with the financial education vertical, talking about Venture and FutureSmart. But I did want to share with you all of these other resources available to you at no cost. So as today, we're going to really specifically think about those financial literacy programs. Do know that we also have STEM and career readiness. We know how often this can go hand in hand with our financial education, but as well as social emotional learning, health, wellness, early academic readiness, and diversity, equity, inclusion. So as you're thinking about different initiatives that you have for your own school and classroom or district, know that these resources are also available to you at no cost. And then specifically here, you can check out some of those middle school resources. But let's get to the bulk of it. Why are we here today? Why financial literacy? Why did all of you take some time out at 2 o'clock on your Tuesday afternoon? And it's exactly to the points that Kevin shared with us today. Really, we're not prepared as a country to think about our financial futures. I heard Kevin mention, you know, we're really thinking about the here and now and not planning for what's to come. So 4 in 10 US consumers reported that they had trouble paying at least one bill or expense in the past year. And then we also 9% of students from low-income communities graduate from college. And oftentimes this is correlated to their financial ability to fund it. So helping students think about what are the tools and resources they have to be able to prepare for that future. So EVERFI's goal is really to move us from financial literacy, which is really helping students to just understand how money works and get them into that financial capability. So financial capability is helping them think about their knowledge, habits, and confidence. So in addition to when they are going through these digital resources, giving them these vocabulary words, helping them understand key concepts, they're actually practicing these skills in different scenarios that are relatable to where they're at in their life. So students are going through them, they're being able to play out these experiences in a safe learning environment to see what the potential outcomes might be, helping them to build confidence, helping them to think about what does it mean to have financial well-being. And that component too, we also survey students. So as we're thinking about our middle school students, they complete a survey before and after the course. And in that, we're able to see how their attitudes and change and how they're feeling change in regard to the confidence in making these financial decisions. And that's all data that we can share back with our districts so that you can see how these different programs are impacting your students. So EVERFI offers financial education at every stage. So today, you know, yesterday we spent some time with our elementary educators talking about our vault understanding money for 4th through 6th grade. We really think of this as that first platform in laying that foundation of financial knowledge. But as we're moving into middle school, this is where our students are really starting to understand more of these concepts, starting to experiencing some of them firsthand. So that is, we'll talk about FutureSmart and Venture today. So I know we also talked about the importance of entrepreneurship. And we know that entrepreneurship is a really incredible pathway for some of those students that are just not sure what they want for their future, helping them to see that they can build their own path. So this course is going to talk about entrepreneurship, how to start a business, but also helping them to think about how do I make sure that I'm planning for my budget? How do I make sure that I am getting that seed money or finding investors, giving them some of those key basics. And then of course, we also offer an entire suite of high school financial literacy. So on this screen, just simply showing our foundational, really what we call our 101 course for high school. But we have an entire suite talking about financing higher education, modern banking and identity protection, and even investing basics. So let's dive into FutureSmart. So FutureSmart is sponsored by the MassMutual Foundation. So they are funding this program for all middle school students across the entire US. The program's really designed for 6th through 8th grade. So for a key point of reference, oftentimes our the low grade listed, so here 6th grade, is often where the reading level is at. But all EVERFI programs have audio support throughout. So as students are completing this course, they're able to listen in, hear the audio, as well as see the text, as well as images that go along with that, really making sure that our students can comprehend no matter where their reading level is at. This includes 7 lessons, about 20 to 25 minutes each, and it's also available in Spanish. So I'm happy to show you all today, but they can change language right there in their dashboard. So if this is something your students are doing at home, they're having conversations with their family, they can certainly change it over to Spanish to really create that more inclusive community for them. In this course, our students are become mayor of their town, and their goal is to help their constituents make smart financial decisions. So for example, in this lesson two here, students talk about investing in your future, and this young man wants to redecorate his room. And students first go through an activity of identifying wants versus needs, but then they need to go shopping for these items. And as they're going shopping, they're looking at unit price, they're looking at opportunity cost, they're thinking about their budget. All of these components come in a real world application of what our students might experience themselves. Each of the lessons, they are building on different concepts. They start with a personal assessment. How do they feel about money? How do they save money? Helping them to think about this. And ultimately at the end of the course, students build a blueprint for their future. So let's watch a quick video. So throughout all of this, it's all simulation based, putting students in different scenarios, and they're getting rated by their constituents. So helping it feel like that gamified experience, they get to pick an avatar, really helping them to think about how this might be applicable in my real life.
By the time students reach middle school, they have already developed the capacity to understand complex economic concepts, make financial judgments, and assign value to purchases and brands. Yet, the majority of today's students don't have the money management skills they need to navigate the modern financial world. The Mass Mutual Foundation has partnered with EVERFI to develop the FutureSmart digital course, which offers critical financial literacy for middle school students across the United States, absolutely free of charge. FutureSmart empowers students to effectively manage their finances, make sound decisions, and become financially responsible. After taking an initial financial personality quiz, students are elected mayor of their very own town, charged with helping the townspeople navigate personal financial challenges. Through a story-based narrative and interactive activities, students learn to make real-life decisions about their own personal finances, as well as how to achieve important goals around topics like saving money, education and career planning, and budgeting. Visit everfi.com/K-12 to learn more and get started with this free resource today.
Don't want to make you watch that again, but back to the point around knowledge gain. So each year we provide those two impact reports. We provide a report in January that's going to show those mid-year knowledge gains, and then we provide a report in June and July for that full year knowledge gain. So here's where you can actually see for your district aggregate data of how students are responding to those pre and post assessments for each lesson. So you'll notice here that students across California, specifically here, in the smart shopping one that I discussed a minute ago of helping students to think about redecorating a room, what are some of my choices, students started at a 43% on their pre-assessment and jumped all the way to an 80% on their post-assessment. If we look at your financial future, where students were evaluated on what are the different types of insurance, what's an investment portfolio, what is compound interest, students started at a 37% and jumped all the way to a 79%. So really seeing significant knowledge gains from before and after completing each of these lessons. As mentioned before, we're really working on getting our students towards that financial capability. And a part of that is that survey component. So on the far right is where you're going to see that increased student preparedness. So 67% of students are feeling more prepared or somewhat prepared after taking the course to open and manage their own savings or checking account. Alongside this, it's always asking, working with your parents, do you plan to open a savings account? But then 66% up from 55 are planning for their financial future. So this is one course, less than 3 hours of completion, really changing some of the mindsets of our students. And speaking of that, sometimes it doesn't want to move forward and then it moves forward too fast. So speaking of that, we actually completed in this study with Massachusetts Donahue Institute to really identify, is FutureSmart making an impact on students? So we looked at knowledge gain, student confidence and self-efficacy, communication with family on financial topics, and engagement with financial systems. And after the completion of this study, where we had a group of students in the same school, same grade levels across the country going through the course, and the same group not going through the course, The data analysis and research has discovered that FutureSmart showed a significant and substantial increase in students' financial knowledge and their intention to engage with financial products in the future. So really incredible to see that across the country, and it was looking at different demographics, different race, social economic, all of this consistently, no matter what group our students fell into, they were still seeing those significant knowledge gains. So we're really excited about this and to know that we are making a difference in these middle school lives. So in addition to FutureSmart, we also have our Venture Entrepreneurial Expedition. In this course that is designed for 7th through 10th grade with four lessons, just 20 to 25 minutes each, students are getting to build a food truck. So first, they are going through a lesson where they are identifying what does it mean to be an entrepreneur? What are the different skill sets? And it's actually connecting them to famous entrepreneurs. So giving students an opportunity to explore what are my different qualities, what kind of entrepreneur might I be? They then start to develop their food truck. So as a CTE entrepreneurship student, this follows exactly those different business plans. Students will go through and think about, okay, what are the different demographics? How much should I charge for this? Who should I hire? So based on my strengths, what are the different things that I should be looking for in others? And then students will also go into thinking about how they are getting their startup funds, thinking about their budget, how much should they charge for their products to make sure that they are earning that profit. And then finally, it comes down to the pitch. So I know Kevin and I, prior to this call, we're talking about the different things that our schools are doing for entrepreneurship. Students are actually practicing their pitch. They can record it within the platform so that they can make sure that they really refine that. So this one, we oftentimes will see students go through FutureSmart first and then follow up with Venture, really kind of elevating to that next level as they're going through their personal finance experience. So we did want to connect with a teacher in our network. So we have some teachers joining us on Thursday, but due to scheduling, they weren't able to join us today. But Austin at Acacia Middle School shared a few different components from her experience implementing EVERFI resources. So one of the students, feedback, they love being able to get through the lessons self-paced and being able to do it on their own. That independence. So these resources are all designed to be web-based. Students working through them independently, completing those pre and post assessments for each of the lessons. This is automatically graded for you as teachers. So really taking that lift off your plate, but also allowing students to have the asynchronous learning experience. She also shared that she likes that the lessons were engaging and students were able to access lessons alone during independent learning. So back to that, asynchronous learning, but we've also seen this done in small groups within classrooms, or if you are a counselor, pulling small groups together. There's a lot of flexibility with implementation, and we know every single school has different needs. So we are happy to work alongside you to think about how this would work for your students. Any questions about our financial capability programs, how they might work in your classroom? Grading, everything is on the table. Feel free to ask whatever questions you might have. Any questions, Mariana? Not yet.
None that have come by. I know they're excited to get onto the course, though.
Awesome.
They're checking it out.
Yeah, I don't see questions either, Jessica, but I'm just like here, like taking notes as we're writing. This is great stuff, and folks are kind of saying, hey, this is awesome. When can we try this out? I want to get this ready and use it in my class. See, there's a question there. Would you start middle school advanced students in math with Venture?
Yeah, Dr. Harris, that's a great question. I would start them with FutureSmart. Even if they are your more advanced students, they might work through those lessons more quickly. If I go back here really quick to FutureSmart, for example, one of the things too that I like to think about our programs and I failed to mention is they're really buffet style. So other than the first lesson where students are completing an evaluation of who they are, students can pick and choose, or educators, you can pick and choose which lessons you want them to go through. So even if you're working with a pretty advanced group, maybe you don't need them to go through that first lesson on investing in your future, but you want them to think about savings and investing and risk versus return. You have the flexibility to have them jump directly to those lessons and complete those. So if you want to make sure they have some of that foundational knowledge before jumping to venture, I definitely recommend that as a best practice. Yeah. So all of our programs have a lot of flexibility with implementation. And so that is where Andee and I are here to help really think about what it might look like for your class, thinking about the different alignment. What is it that students need? You know, maybe it is just a budgeting and opportunity cost lesson. You don't have to have them go through all seven lessons, you know, for the 3 hours of content. Great. So we're going to get to it. It sounds like this group is like, let's get in these resources. Let's check them out. Before we do that, I want to share a few quick things that are super important. Data. So as mentioned, all of these pre and post assessments for each lesson are automatically graded for you, and it goes directly to your teacher dashboard. So you're able to see a color-coded dashboard with 70% or higher showing up in green, 60% and lower showing up in red. So you're able to get a quick look at how your students are performing, what objectives that they are mastering. If you're seeing students are struggling with a specific objective, this is where you can move into our lesson tools. So for all of our resources, we have extension lesson plans, discussion guides, course outlines, curriculum guides, everything you might need to expand on these topics. So we really want this to be as plug and play and low lift for you as educators as possible. We know you have a lot on your plate. You're managing a lot of different initiatives and goals. We want to make financial literacy an easy component to incorporate into your classroom. So all of that's created for you, allowing you to just pull directly from your teacher dashboard. As mentioned, we have a whole library of resources, so in the extension, definitely feel free to check those out today when we get you in the dashboard. And then student scholarships and events. So speaking of our student scholarships, Mariana is going to chat in these three scholarship opportunities. So I know yesterday we had a few, we had our elementary team coming in. Oh, and I think we have the wrong, Mariana, I think I shared the wrong link here for the Knowledge for College one. Let me grab that link really quick. I just realized that. So for high school, we have a Pathways student blog contest. I'm going to chat that in right now. So ignore that first link on the page here. But that first link, so if you have high school students, you're working with students that are freshmen, this scholarship is available. We have 10 $1,000 scholarships available for California students. Right now, inside track, since you are here with me at 2:30 on a Tuesday, we only have 7 applicants for this. So if you work with a colleague at the high school, you have your own high school student, certainly check out this scholarship opportunity. And then FutureSmart, we just talked about this course. We have 10 1,529 scholarships. Students just have to complete 3 lessons. So as mentioned, they don't have to go through the whole course and then submit a short essay. So here is where you can go in, complete that short essay. Deadline is May 31st. And then we also have an all student spring scholarship contest. So again, $1,000 529 savings plan. We provide all the information and directions for our students and families on how to use that 529 plan, but just a great opportunity to start getting the students thinking about their financial futures. And then upcoming events, we are partnering with Sallie Mae for Knowledge for College Family Night on Tuesday, May 11th and Wednesday, May 12th. So we have a planning for college session and then finding free money, because nothing is better than that free money. So definitely if you have families that are starting to think about this, I work with a few college counselors and different districts where they are saying, hey, by the time our students are freshmen, they've already started to make up decisions about, will I go on to higher education? And so they're starting to think about, how do we get this into our 7th, 8th graders, helping them think about what their financial future and what financing higher ed might look like. So a great introduction for those middle school students as well. Okay, let's get started. Let's get to it so you can see the courses. This is the fun part. This is what you've all signed up for this webinar for. So if you are a new to EVERFI, and I think most of this group might be, definitely you wanna go to everfi.com/new-teacher. From here, you're going to use the dropdown and find California. and then begin typing in your school name. Once you have found your school, if you cannot find your school for any reason, ping us, let us know. We can hunt it down for you and make sure it's in our system. But once you've found your school, go ahead and hit next. And then you're going to have a short form to complete. So here is where you're going to enter your first name, last name, your school email address, and password. From the Select Course dashboard, I recommend selecting FutureSmart or Venture. And then agree to the terms of service. Once you've done this, if you will give a thumbs up emoji in there, let us know in the chat that you're good before we move forward. So I'll give everyone a second to register.
Jessica, we have a question. If someone's here from our district office leadership, should they just select any school in their district?
Yeah, I can also send you, I'm going to send a direct message with our demo account for districts so that you can log in and check it out that way.
Okay. And I also think there was another, I saw Marcus Witter as well earlier. He might, if he's on or comes back, he'd be another one from Desert Sands Unified.
Yeah, perfect. I think I worked with him a few times.
And during this registration process, make sure you're typing in the password twice. Sometimes that gets jumped over, and make sure to click that I agree. Because if not, and you click next, everything kind of wipes itself clean and you have to do it all over again. So we want to make sure everyone doesn't have to do that.
Thanks, Mariana.
Thank you, Crystal. We have another Desert Sands Unified District Office.
Okay. Crystal? Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and share it with everybody. Okay. It's nothing top secret. If you are a teacher, really recommend creating your own account. You don't want to go in here because if you set up cohorts, anything in here, then it won't be in your account. But if you are at a district, this is the username and password you will use. It's california@demo.com. 1234567 8, really top secret. But you're going to go to everfi.com/login to sign in. And that'll give you access to clarify for anyone at the district office. It's going to give you access to all of our different programs. So definitely today you'll just want to focus in on FutureSmart and Venture, but it's going to have all of the programs on there, which typically our teacher dashboards only have the ones that you're interested in. If you are a school admin, I would just sign in as a teacher, absolutely. So we'll give everyone another minute or two. And again, if you'll give us the thumbs up emoji or let us know that you are set, that'll give me indication that we should move forward. Okay, Jessica Mendoza, what school district are you in? I don't believe Desert Sands is Clever Integrated, so it should let you in. So, oh, you are. Are we Clever Integrated? Okay, if you're Clever Integrated in Desert Sands, you are actually going to go through a different process. So we were hoping to capture some of you. So actually, if you go to EVERFI.com new teacher, there is a login with Clever button that you'll want to select. Or you can go to everfi.com/login and click log in with Clever. So everfi.com/login and then select log in with Clever. I'm going to show some directions too on the Clever integration here in a second too. Awesome. So a few thumbs up come up. So we're gonna go ahead and move forward. If anyone has any questions though, definitely feel free to send a direct message to Mariana and I, and we can certainly help make sure you get into the platform. So So once you agree to the terms of service, you're going to be brought to a screen that looks something like this. Most of you, the course that you'll see here is going to be listed as FutureSmart. The first thing that we're going to do is make sure we have all the resources in our dashboard that we're interested in. So if you added FutureSmart and you're like, hey, I really would like to check out Venture 2, we're going to go in and add that. So you can select Add Course or select Catalog. Add Course or Catalog. Once you're here, you are going to see our entire library of resources broken down by the different verticals. So you'll see health and wellness, financial literacy. You want to scroll down to the financial literacy vertical, and here's where you can find Venture or FutureSmart, depending upon which one you added. Simply click the green add button if that is a resource you're interested in reviewing, and it will add it directly to your teacher dashboard. If for whatever reason it says request, that's just going to send Andee a notification. She's probably sitting at her computer right now, and she will go ahead and fulfill that so you can get access. We have those requests in there in case, let's say you are an elementary teacher and you request one of our high school programs. It allows us to send you a quick note to say, hey, want to make sure you know that this is a high school program. Do you need any support? Or are you wanting to use this for acceleration? Whatever. It's really our ability to be more consultative with the work that you're doing. Once you've added all the courses, so again, just hitting that green button to add, go ahead and select home again. So if you go back to your homepage, now you'll see all the courses that you have added. From here, we're going to create our first class. So for our Clever Integrated, I'm going to share with you your directions, but for our non-Clever Integrated, I'll walk you through that as well. But everyone can hit this Create Class button next to any of the courses that you're interested in using. Once you've hit Create Class, in our traditional registration, so for the most of you that went through this, here's where you're going to name the class, whatever makes sense to you. So I might put Miss Golden's 8th grade All-Stars, put that in there, my start date, indicate which class size and grade level. If I am a Clever teacher, from here in the class name, you can select from the drop-down menu, you'll see all of your different rosters listed. From here, you'll be able to select the rosters that you are interested in. So if you know that you want to use it with your third period social studies, whatever that might be, you'll be able to select those rosters from the drop-down. Next, you're going to want to hit add courses. So if I'm an 8th grade teacher or counselor, and I know that I want my students to have access to both FutureSmart and Venture, I'm going to select add courses. And here I'm going to see all those courses that I just added to my dashboard. I'm going to go ahead and check the box next to any of the resources I'm going to be sure my students will have access to. Once I've done that, I'm going to simply click add. And then for those of you that are not Clever Integrated, you are going to see a pop-up. That pop-up is going to include a class code. This code is what your students will then use to self-register. So they'll follow a really similar process to what you all did as teachers to go ahead, and this will put them right into your gradebook. If you are Clever Integrated and you selected your roster, the next time your students go into their Clever app, select EVERFI, they will see those courses on their dashboard. So no additional step in regard to a registration code. No need to memorize that, by the way. I'm going to show you right now where you can find it. So we will go ahead and take you into that. So right now, go ahead and select from this, you have your dark blue toolbar, and right below that you have classes and this lighter, still royal blue color. Go ahead and select classes. And here's where you'll be able to see all the classes that you ultimately set up. So if I am teaching 8th grade and I have 4 periods that I want to have access, you can set up a class for each of those periods. If I'm a counselor and I'm going into different classrooms, I might set up a classroom or set up a class for each homeroom teacher that I'm going to be engaging with. This is just going to keep it as simple as possible for your gradebook. So here is where you can also come to create a class right here within your classes toolbar. So you can do things on this dashboard multiple ways. oftentimes if you're lost, there's probably another button that'll get you back to where you were trying to do. So always multiple ways to be able to access our resources. But here is where you can find, you can edit this. So if you want to change the name of it, you want to add another resource to it. So maybe you were like, hey, I really like FutureSmart and Venture, but I also know I want my students to get Vault or another resource. You can add it right to that class, but you also have your registration code. So that code your students need to self-register is available right here. You can click on that and find it whenever you are ready. Now the best part, the most important part is being able to get in, see the resources. So this is where you can go in and view the course. And this is gonna take you through similar to a student experience, but there's two differences. One is that you're able to move through this demo account much more quickly than a student can actually move through the digital program. We want them to listen. We want them to complete all the different tasks and assignments as they're going through this, being able to really engage with the content. As teachers, we want to give you, and educators, we want to give you the ability to zoom through this much more quickly. So you can hit the forward arrow much sooner than what a student would be able to. The other component is it's not saving progress. So as this is a demo account, it's not going to track your pre and post assessment scores. And if you leave and come back, it's not going to pick up where you left off. But if I'm a student going through my student account and I have started in your class and then it's time for us to go to lunch or whatever it might be the next period, it's going to save my progress so I can pick up right where I left off. So really making sure students are, you know, we know that not all time periods that you have are exactly 20, 25 minutes. So making sure that our students are able to be flexible with their usage. Do know if you click on that, you might hear some immediate audio. Sometimes it can be startling if you weren't expecting it. So another time where you certainly want your students to have headphones as they are working through these digital lessons. The next piece, and I already recognize that what I am about to show you is going to look a little bit different than your experience on the dashboard, is our resources tab. So if you click this resources tab, it's actually going to open full window. What I am showing you here is just a pop out. Yours is actually a full window now, broken down by different resources, lesson, extension lesson plans, discussion guides, anything you might need to teach this curriculum and expand on these topics has already been developed for you. So again, we want this to be as plug and play and easy to implement for you as possible. So if you look within the resources, here's, you're gonna find glossaries, you're gonna find extension lesson plans. My favorite for any of our programs is the course outline. The course outline will show you the objective, it'll show you what different scenarios we're presenting to students and what different outcomes we are hoping to measure. And then finally, it's important for us to see our student progress. So within reports, this is where you're going to see all of your students that have registered and all of their pre and post assessment scores. So for each module that students, for each module within that digital program, you will see a vertical here broken down so that you'll see a score for each of these. As mentioned before, it's color coded. So it'll be green 70% or higher, red 60% or lower. So being able to give a really quick look, you can recommend to the students that don't pass it with a green, hey, let's go back and retake those assessments or retake those lessons. And also if you select the view, you can even see a timestamp for when students completed it. So if you're setting different deadlines and due dates, you can actually see when students have gone through those digital programs and completed them. And key part two is the save as CSV. So you have the opportunity to download and save this as a CSV to upload into your gradebook. So if you are using these for grades, you can download that CSV file and upload it into your different gradebook systems. And if you're looking for specific students, you can also just search for them by name. Students, here is where we know inevitably a student's gonna forget a password. So here you can come in and you can hit edit. You can change their password. If you need to move students from classes, you certainly can here. If you are in a clever integrated class and a student moves, it'll move through your information system. So you certainly won't need to do that on our end. No changing passwords either. So this is really just applicable for those schools that are going through our traditional registration process. And then the best part, support. So here listed under Schools Manager, you will see Andee's contact information. So if you lose this presentation and you log in your account, you're like, hey, I really could use some help or a thought partner to think about how to use these programs in my classroom, you can come here and you'll find Andee's contact information as well as scholarship opportunities listed here. And then invite a teacher. We are always wanting to spread the word about EVERFI resources. So if you have other colleagues at your school that you might think might be interested in these at the high school, elementary, or even across the country that you think would be interested in using these programs, invite a teacher. Once you get started and they get started, and if they're brand new to EVERFI, you will receive a $15 Amazon gift card to your inbox. So it's just our way of thanking you for helping us spread the word about these resources. And then the student registration process. So for those of you that did create registration codes, your students will go to everfi.com/register. You want to make sure that they are on the student learner section. They will input that registration code from your class. Hit next, and then they have a short form to complete. Do note that it asks for their birthday. We ask for this as simply just a flag if they are 13 or over for COPA compliance. So we are not actually saving any student birthdays in our system. They'll put in their first and last name, first name, last initial if they are under 13. They'll put in a username and password, and that's it. So that's the only information collecting from students. And the first and last name is simply for the teacher gradebook. And then they'll hit next and they'll be right on their teacher dashboard. I'm gonna zoom through these clever slides. If you know that you are clever integrated with EVERFI, send us a note. We'll make sure that you are all set. But most of what we share today is gonna be really similar, except just maybe a little bit easier, quite frankly. And so for our district context on here, if you all know that you use Clever, you want to make this as easy as possible for your teachers, but we maybe have not integrated together with EVERFI and Clever, we are happy to talk through that and make sure that it's easy, streamlined, and your teachers and students can get access to the programs more easily. All right. So there is a short Google form. This, as I mentioned, Andee wasn't able to join us today. She is feeling under the weather, but between her and I, we would love to follow up and provide you more customized support based on your school, district, students, what you might need. So Mariana just chatted in a Google form and we'd really love to just open it up. So if you wanna fill that out, let us know who you are. We can provide that more customized follow-up to your needs, but otherwise, we'll open it up for questions. Catalina, I saw you came on camera, so I'll hand it over to you.
No, I just thank you so much to both of you for sharing these resources. And I know we've been getting some private messages, so I'm gonna see if Dr. Gatto got a few messages as well. Let him go first. Of questions.
I did, but they were answered earlier. They were just excited to see this and they just asked me, can we access this? And so I was chatting with Mariana. Thank you so much, team. Great job.
Okay. So I think that's, the summary of it, yes, if you are a teacher, if you, Jessica, can you and share again, if you're a teacher or a school counselor or an administrator that just wants to do this for their school site, you don't necessarily have to wait for the whole district. And I think one of our elementary school teachers really loved yesterday was the pre and post test data that you give for your students, for your school site. Can you just kind of remind everyone there? And it's all free. They don't have to pay for anything. So if you can just kind of share that, because I think some people think, well, does my district have to sign on? Can you go over that, please, one more time, Jessica?
Yeah, of course. So we're working with quite a few districts in Riverside County already. Sometimes it's just a matter of, do you know that or not? But we are happy to work one-to-one with teachers. So if you are like, hey, this is something I'm really interested in doing, I wanna pilot this program this spring, or I know that I wanna integrate it into my curriculum for the fall, we're happy to work one-to-one individually with each teacher. We're also happy to do more school-based. So if you're a school admin and you're saying, hey, this is something I wanna bring to all of, you know, or a few champion teachers that are raising their hands, we're really able to work with you no matter what scale it is that you want to do this. Because if you're a whole district and you're like, hey, we really want to jump on board, we're also happy to work alongside you to come up with an implementation plan and best practices. So our goal is to be as flexible as possible to support the needs of each of you, because we know every school, every student, every situation is unique, and we're just willing to work alongside you to make sure we're addressing those needs. And you know your students best. Nobody knows your students better than you all do. So we're just here to be your thought partner alongside you.
Okay, thank you. And these are trailblazers. With everything going on right now, they're here today on the afternoon, after school day. Some of them are virtual, some of them are in person, and they want to learn more. And I think your willingness to meet with them, even if they're not ready to kick off till next year, like I shared with you, October's college kickoff month, and how they can maybe use some of these lessons within the school day, work with their math teachers. I think if you can share a few other creative groups, so it's not always just on a school counselor or just one set of teachers, some ideas that you've seen, creative ideas in middle schools of different groups that have taken this on.
Yeah, so if any of you have advisory classes, that's really been the hot placement this year. Sometimes we'll have teachers, maybe it's decided in your homeroom advisory, or even if you're a social studies or math teacher, we see a lot of Ever Fridays, or if you have early release days, those are the days that our students are logging in and completing a lesson in EVERFI. We know those short early release days are quick. You don't have a ton of time to get through like a full lesson. That's where we can be a great resource for that. We've also seen all kinds of implementations. So small groups, if we're wanting to pull out specific students, or we have a district that we're working with in Northern Nevada, where they've said, hey, we want to address certain standards. And so the week of May 10th, we're gonna have all of our teachers go through FutureSmart with their students so that we can get that really rich data to see how these programs are impacting. So we have a ton of different use cases of how these programs have been implemented, and we're more than happy to brainstorm and come up with a solution that works for you. Mariana, do you have any other things?
The only thing I was going to say too is, as Jess was showing you the resources that we have, it's also a great way to, you can assign this, you know, the digital version as a homework assignment, and then come back to class and use those lesson plans with the students and really see what they've learned, but also get that hands-on, you know, in the classroom activity with the students to get that conversation going. Because I think the best things that happen are through those conversations, and students start talking about what they learned and how the money, you know, how money works and everything like that. So you start kind of spiraling the conversation from there. So it's a really fun activities that the students have with that. So it's good blended learning type of situation.
Flipped classrooms are great too. So having students work on this independently, going through those lessons and then coming back together, exactly to what Mariana said, and having more of that discussion-based class time. So whatever you all need, we're happy to brainstorm alongside you what might be a good solution.
Okay.
Thank you.
And so everyone knows too, we're gonna do more of this type of maybe incentivizing your as a county for students to participate. You know, this is like Kevin and Dr. Gatto mentioned earlier, this is a big initiative for, you know, Dr. Gomez to really push and ensure our students, as you know, our students, majority of them, and I see some of you coming from the Valley, 70, 80% of your students are first in their family to go to college, et cetera. And they don't maybe get these conversations and savings accounts and planning for the future. It doesn't always happen at home. Some of your parents are just taking it day by day and making ends meet. We'll do FAFSAs with a family of three, and the family makes $15,000 a year. It's like, how are you talking about these things with your students? So we kind of take that on in our county. They're school dependent. And so these are great ways to start introducing some of these concepts that they may not hear at home. So I know we're almost end of time. I wanna make sure we have any last minute, any questions, if you wanna put them in the chat. This is just the beginning of plenty of more sessions to come and supports for our middle school leaders like yourselves. Dr. Gatto, anything else, any implementation ideas or anything else you've been seeing?
I would just definitely, I know there's folks out there, we're not a big bunch today, but if anybody starts to trailblaze this work and get it going and have some ideas and creative ways to get this to the kids, please, please share that with us. I don't know if there's a slide there on deck, but if not, I'll put my email there. Let us know. We'd love to see any best practices, innovative ways that you're getting this out to our kiddos and their families, so that we can spread this financial literacy approach around the entire county. So please reach out to us. Thank you so much, Nia, for that. Let us know. We'd love to see it in action, come to your school, work with you, and make this bigger, better so that more kids are benefiting from this. Thank you.
Okay, So I don't see any additional questions. I'm sure more will come. Any final thoughts, Jessica or Mariana, before we close out?
Thank you so much for your time today. We know you have a lot going on as we're closing out the school year, getting students back on campus. So thank you for taking the time to learn more about this. And we're really excited to work with you all.
Thank you. Awesome. We do have a session tonight for parents and students about understanding credit reports. So looking forward to more of those. And thank you for being here. We know how busy you are, but we're here to support you, even if it's planning for next year. All right, thank you, everyone. Have a great day.
Bye, everyone.
The PowerPoint and the video as well, the recording. Okay, bye-bye.